Earlier this month, the U.S. Air Force literally dropped a giant curtain to reveal its latest fighter jet, the F-15EX Eagle II. The ceremony at Eglin Air Force Base in Florida marked the official debut of the twin-engine aircraft, complete with puffs of fog to set the scene. Despite some complaints about the jet's uncreative new name, the Boeing-made fighter deserves a close look. Brand new aircraft models don't often enter service, and when they do, they fly for decades. This model F-15 is the latest in a long line of aircraft with similar names dating back to the 1970s, so it can be hard to know precisely what is new about this gray-winged machine. Here's everything you might want to know about the F-15EX Eagle II and its metal ancestors, plus what one pilot says is the craft's key weakness in 21st century battles. The history of the F-15 Eagle. The Eagle is a child of the 1960s and 1970s, and it had a straightforward purpose: to excel at air-to-air fighting. It comes from this unique historical moment, says Michael Hankins, a curator with the National Air and Space Museum who is writing a book on both the F-15 and F-16. He pegs its genesis in 1964. There's a faction of folks, within the Air Force anyway, that have this idea that the traditional fighter mission, focusing on air-to-air combat, has not been adequately paid attention to. The Eagle grew out of that single-purpose mission. The catchphrase became "not a pound for air-to-ground," Hankins says, meaning the plane wouldn't be equipped for dropping bombs. It was all about air-to-air fighting. It's a simple idea: create a flying hammer, not an airborne Swiss Army knife. The plane flew for the first time in the early 1970s, and Hankins says that in the decades since it has executed its mission superbly. It's got an incredible reputation, he notes. You can't deny that the F-15 is one of the best air-to-air fighters in history, and I think it's one of the most iconic. The F-15EX, the newest Eagle. The latest version of the Eagle, officially called the Eagle II, is what will carry aviators into that life-or-death contest. The C&D model F-15s are getting old, so this is what will replace them. Pilots will now have a high-definition color touchscreen that measures 19 by 10 inches. A secondary screen is in the back seat for use if the rear spot is occupied, although the plane will probably be occupied by just a single person most of the time. The Eagle II is now completely fly-by-wire too. Instead of those previous gen pulleys and cables, the plane now digitally interprets how the pilot moves the controls, and then electronic signals talk to the rest of the aircraft. Pilots sometimes say that with this kind of aircraft, human aviators are just voting. They vote by moving the stick to tell the plane what they'd like it to do, while the flight control computer figures the rest out. The plane also has what's known as an open mission system backbone, says Major Aaron Eshkenazi, a pilot with the Air Force who has been flying the F-15EX. That makes the aircraft more modular. Engineers can plug software code into it for a new sensor or weapon, for example, and that system is isolated from our safety of flight. Finally, the Eagle II is similar to what Boeing has already been making for foreign customers: the F-15SA for Saudi Arabia and the QA for Qatar. The Air Force says it may purchase as many as 144 of them. There's one big thing the F-15 Eagle II can't do. On the outside, the aircraft has a decades-old design, and that means there's one thing it's not: stealthy. Fifth-generation fighter jets, like the F-35, are designed to evade enemy radar. The F-15EX, or any other Eagle, is as loud and obvious as a football player. And for that reason, Heather Penny, who flew Vipers for a decade, call sign Lucky, is critical of the purchase. The context behind the purchase, she says, has roots in two issues: One is that it's expensive for the Air Force to continually maintain fleets of dated jets. The average age of an Air Force fighter nowadays is about 30 years old, she says. She notes that the F-16 she flew dates to 1985, and it's still kicking around. The other concern is the Air Force's desire to diversify its base away from just Lockheed Martin-made jets like the F-35. The Eagle II is made by Boeing. She argues that a modern fighter jet should have a triad of capabilities: stealth, information systems presented to the pilot in a manageable way, and the ability to conduct electronic warfare and jam an enemy. You cannot put this aircraft in the battle space because it's missing one of those legs, Penny says. It's a big shiny metal object. Predictably, some F-15 pilots disagree with that assessment. Eshkenazi, who is flying the F-15EX now, notes that the platform can carry a larger weapons payload than the F-35. For example, it can hold a dozen AMRAAM missiles. He also points out that the Eagle makes a good distraction when paired with a stealth fighter, the same way a magician might pull your eyes towards something shiny to keep you from noticing a sneaky move. The Eagle could fly with an F-22 or F-35, for example, and the adversary's eyes would be on the Eagle. It allows my 5th-gen and 6th-gen partners to go in undetected, Eshkenazi notes. Camp, the former Eagle pilot, agrees. Simply being seen can be a deterrence. Our task is to clear the skies, he says. We don't have to shoot one missile, we have to put fear in the enemy's eyes and have them turn away and go home.